Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Commodity TV in a new edition of our online interview series. Today, we want to get an update from GoldMining, and Alastair, still the CEO, is here with us. Good morning to Canada. How are you, Alastair?
Hey, good morning. Pleasure to be here today. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thanks for taking the time, GoldMining. I'm a shareholder of the company, of course, and well, at these days, maybe not so happy with the share price, but it is what it is. Those are the markets. But I'm really happy with your last news flow. And let's get started with the Almaden property where you did that, like optioning and possibly sale to Nefgold. And I mean, you bought it so cheap and you get now all in $16.5 million. Man, what a deal.
Well, we think it's a great deal, and we think ultimately it's a win-win for both sides. We've partnered with Nevgold, who are a very strong explorer in the region. They have a solid property in Nevada, which they've been drilling this year and having encouraging results there. So we've evaluated them and their team, and we still think there's a lot of upside at Almaden. So although we're getting a good upfront payment and makes a good headline number now, what makes us excited is that as Nevgold works the property, we retain equity in Nevgold, their company, and we share in the upside. So it's a true win-win scenario. And as you point out, you know, we acquired the property just about 2 years ago for just over $1 million Canadian. And to see, you know, 16-fold return in 2 years is great for our shareholders. And we still have the upside as they explore the property further.
Super. So you said you get an upfront payment. How much is it in cash? And how does it work then with the share payments?
Yeah, the payments are going to be in shares. Initial payments are in shares. The first payment was $3 million in shares, and that will be on closing, which should be in the next week or so. There's a series of milestones over the next 18 to 24 months where they have to do work in the ground. They issue more shares to earn in. And I would describe it as an all or nothing earn in. There's no partial ownership. They either complete the option or they walk away and we retain the shares that they've paid us at that point in time. And on once they've vested into the property, we also share in some of the future contingent payments as they advance the project down the traditional project pipeline through various studies, economic right through to feasibility and production. So it's tracking well. It makes a lot of intuitive sense for them as they grow the region. It gives our shareholders some great results up front in terms of a win, and we get to share as they drill forward. So a good scenario all around.
That's super. Yeah, and the thing is, you must not spend your money, but you are still in the boat with them.
Absolutely. I think, especially in this market, everyone needs to make smart deals. It's a good deal for us. It's a good deal for them. All the cash is going effectively into the ground. Part of this transaction also involves us making a strategic investment into Nevgold. That money effectively has to all be spent on the property itself. So everybody wins in that scenario.
Super, perfect. Then let's move from Nevada to Colombia. I mean, we had an election there. Maybe you can say some words on that, if you are affected or not, what you think. That might be interesting also for our viewers. But I think you had a phenomenal drill result with 345 meters at 0.74 grams gold equivalent. And also, if we look at the intercepts and the other lengths you have published, one might think, those are low grades. Why they are so excited?
Well, a lot of questions there. I guess the first one to tackle is the recent election. Colombia did elect a new president recently. No immediate impacts on us. I mean, it's still very much a very stable country. The new president is a little more left-leaning for sure than the past president. And so we'll see how that develops. But we don't see any immediate plans or impacts on our activities or operations at this point. So all good on that front, on the political scene. On the drilling front, yes, we're extremely excited by the drill results. It's a very important milestone for GoldMining Inc. You know, we've made a shift to actually put work into the property. So this is effectively our first drill program. La Garrucha is a great target. It's less than a kilometer away from the existing resources at La Mina. So it can be very quickly added in to the economic studies and the mine plans that we've been doing there as we move towards a resource year end. What I would say about the intercept, we're very encouraged. I mean, this is our first section of holes, the first two holes. 345 meters is an exceptional width. We're very excited by that. And I would point out that the hole actually ended in mineralization. So we are going to deepen that hole. So it still continues. Mm-hmm. So it is open at this point. The grade that we've seen, a 0.74 gram per ton, that's over almost 350 meters. So that's an exceptional mm-hmm. width. It's a solid grade. I would compare that to our cutoff grade that we used in the preliminary economic assessment, which was 0.25 gram per ton, which is basically the break-even grade where we can make money at that deposit, various economic factors included, mm-hmm. at a $1,600 gold price. So mm-hmm. we're encouraged by that grade. And of course, within that 345 meters, we have significantly higher grade intervals as well, per ton gold equivalent in a couple of zones. And really future drilling will see the continuity of the higher grade sections, but we do have a very large system there, certainly very amenable mm-hmm. to bulk scale open pit mining, which is very efficient, which lets us keep the cutoff grades very low.
Mm-hmm. Okay, super. And with the depths of like 260, 255 meters, I mean, we are talking probably about an open pit. So how does that fit in the whole model?
Well, we certainly have used the open pit as our base case scenario there for our economic assumptions, our cutoff mm-hmm. grades. But what encourages us is that we still don't know what happens at depth at this deposit. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the reality of these types of systems, these large scale porphyry systems, they often have high grade feeders at depth. That to me represents a future upside potential. Not something I think we'll target immediately, but certainly as we model the deposit, as we understand it better, it remains open at depth, which would include studying various options for higher grade portions that could be amenable for underground mining.
Mm-hmm. Okay, super. So all in all, Colombia looks great.
Yeah, very encouraging. And again, the other point I would make about the intercept that we've reported there, it's a very consistent grade. We don't see a lot mm-hmm. of spikiness, you know, one high grade interval carrying over a broad mm-hmm. area. This is a consistent zone of mineralization with both copper and gold mineralization, mm-hmm. relatively stable, which is a very positive thing for modeling the deposit, very positive thing for eventual mining on it and grade control. When you have good predictability, good consistency of grades, it's exactly what you want to see when you have a large scale open pit deposit.
Mm-hmm. Okay, super. Yeah, then let's switch to the US. US Gold Mining Inc., where the Whistler project is in. What's the status there?
Well, that's another one that we're extremely excited about, and we're looking forward to moving forward this year with our own drill program at Whistler, which hasn't seen drilling in over 10 years on that project as well. But your followers will have noticed that we did announce earlier this year we created a new entity called US Gold Mining Inc. to specifically focus on Whistler. We really love the jurisdiction, Alaska. We love the U.S. focus. We think, you know, keeping projects onshore at home in America is a good thing for the American economy, good thing for American mm-hmm. jobs. Alaska is very supportive of the resource industry. And in fact, the state is funding a road to resources program. They've invested over $8.5 million of state money studying the feasibility for a road that could access this part of the state for resource mm-hmm. development and drilling. So that's very encouraging in addition to our work. And what we've also done with this project, we've built up a team. We announced a very strong board of directors with a focus on ESG, environment, a very solid and experienced board. We've brought in a new CEO to run US Gold Mining Inc., who happens to be very experienced, Tim Smith, a global mm-hmm. exploration geologist. He's had great success in the north. He led a discovery at Kaminak across the border in Yukon. Had over 5 million ounces of gold discovered there that was eventually acquired by Goldcorp for over $500 million. Mm-hmm. So Tim will lead our exploration efforts and be the CEO of the new company. It's a great fit. Tim's mm-hmm. been spending a lot of time in Alaska lately. We're getting the camp rehabbed. We're getting our final permits sorted out and in order, getting logistics set for a very exciting milestone, which we'll be drilling later this year.
Mm-hmm, super. So how does that work then with US Gold Mining Inc. and the Whistler project in there? How do the shareholders of Gold Mining benefit of that?
It's a great question. And we think we had a great model for success last year when we spun out and created Gold Royalty Corp. You know, our listeners and shareholders will know that we took our portfolio of assets, we wrote small royalties on them, put them into a new vehicle called Gold Royalty Corp. We launched that publicly on the New York Stock Exchange. It raised $90 million, mm-hmm. and the beneficiary of that is Gold Mining and its shareholders. We retain 20 million shares. That's on our balance sheet. We've crystallized that value. We see a very similar model to mm-hmm. US Gold Mining Inc. We plan to go through a public launch, an IPO of that later this year. We'll be able to raise money for that to explore the property. There'll be no dilution to our existing shareholders, and GoldMining benefits from strength, adding to our balance sheet as we increase value and crystallize that value onto our balance sheet. So we see that model already has shown great success for us, unlocking value with Gold Royalty Corp. That's the perfect model for our next venture, which is US Gold Mining Inc.
Okay, super. Then hopefully we get a better market because the Gold Royalty share price halved since the IPO, which is not nice, but I mean, the company is in great shape, actually.
Well, the company is
but
in great shape. And the
yeah,
other benefit
super,
of having
right?
those shares in Gold Royalty Corp is they're now paying us a dividend. We're getting now close to $1 million a year in dividend income by owning those shares. So that's an added benefit, particularly in these environments where we can have cash coming in as a junior explorer. That's an added benefit of owning those Gold Royalty shares right now.
Yeah, that's super. No, I like it also that you really hold also equity stakes because I think this is the best call option without a bank against you for gold.
Yeah, absolutely. As you and your followers will know, we're highly levered to the price of gold. I mean, as we're recording this, we're in that $1,800-$1,850 per ounce range, which actually is a very solid gold price. We've seen a general sell-off in the markets, but gold price has remained relatively flat. To me, that yells out there's a buying and a value opportunity here. The gold miners and the gold equities have been sold off like everything else recently, but the fundamentals are still very solid. It's still a great investment, especially a company like GoldMining Inc., which is so highly levered to the price of gold.
Exactly. Super. Last question. Your Joker, Rhea Uranium Project. What's going on there? Because uranium, my feeling is we are quite close to the next big move.
Well, we're very excited about Rhea, and it's an interesting project to have because, of course, uranium is not our core focus. It's a project we have in our portfolio from a previous acquisition. It's like having a free option on a uranium project. I mean, this is a project that sits in one of the most attractive exploration areas and production areas for uranium on the planet. We have mines producing in that camp, which are 100 times the global grade of uranium deposits elsewhere. You see 50 and $100 million market cap junior exploration companies springing up all over the place with, postage stamp, little small land packages. And here we are sitting with Rhea, very large land package, 125,000 hectares in one of the most productive exploration and producing uranium areas on the planet, and it's waiting to be unlocked. So stay tuned for that one. We continue to look at opportunities, how we can crystallize value in what really amounts to a free optionality on a uranium property in a gold-focused company.
Okay, super. So for the next 6 months, because the first half ends tomorrow, so what important developments do you see for the second half of this year? What can we expect from your company?
Well, great question, and we continue to be excited by the ongoing drilling at La Garrucha at our La Mina project. So stay tuned for further drill results as we complete that 3,600-meter drill program. Those will be coming out in the coming weeks and months. We continue to move forward on Whistler with US Gold Mining Inc. As we gear up for activities at the project and as we get ready for a public launch, stay tuned there. That's a very exciting project. And one we haven't really talked about today, but one which should stay on everyone's radar is our San Jorge project in Brazil, a very high-grade open pit deposit. It's north of a gram per ton gold, measured, indicated, inferred, some 1.4 million ounces right beside a highway in Brazil. It's one we've been doing work on. We're continuing to model. We've done some resampling. Myself and our new VP Exploration will be going down to Brazil in the coming short while to finalize some further activities on that project. So stay tuned for some updates on San Jorge as well. But overall, it speaks to, the great success we've had over the last short while, advancing our projects and continuing to unlock and daylight value in a portfolio that's highly undervalued right now.
Super. Perfect. Thank you very much, Alastair. That sounds like a good game plan, I would say. And yeah, I'm really curious on your drill results then from La Garrucha and also Colombia and Brazil, what's going on there. And I would say keep it going and we talk quite soon.
I look forward to giving you some updates in the very near future. Take care. Speak Super. Again soon.
Thank you very much. Yeah, talk to you soon. Great. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, there was Alastair Still, the CEO of GoldMining, and you heard it. The company is still very active, as always. We are used to that from GoldMining, and things are going well. Great real results. I think also the deal with Nefgold is fantastic and in favor of us shareholders, because I'm a shareholder in the company also. And yeah, I see it very positive all. And as Alastair said, also the deal with Gold Royalty, they get $1 million in dividends every year now. That helps also a lot to finance the company. And yeah, we look forward to drill results and a lot of good news, hopefully, in the second half. Stay tuned. Check out Gold Mining, because the stock is dirt cheap. Really, believe me. And we are bullish for gold. Thanks, and bye-bye from Switzerland.